Next.js developers,
do you wish you could do more with middleware? What if instead of rewriting the URL of a page based on geolocation data, request headers, or cookies, you could actually rewrite the HTML response and update the underlying page props as well, even on a page built using getStaticProps?
Now you can!
Introducing Next.js Advanced Middleware. It's powered by Netlify Edge Functions. It's brand new and only on Netlify. Here is a tutorial. In this tutorial, we're going to use Next.js Advanced Middleware on Netlify to intercept a request to a statically pregenerated page and rewrite the HTML response to change some text and page props based on geolocation data. And then we'll deploy the project to Netlify using the Netlify CLI. I'm your host, Salma Alam-Naylor, and let's get started. Let's check we have everything we need for this tutorial. Check you've got Node installed by running node --version. You'll see that I'm using version 16.16.0, and at the time of writing this tutorial, this is the latest long-term support version. Next, you need a Netlify account. If you're new to Netlify, sign up for free at app.netlify.com/signup. Next, let's install the Netlify CLI. Head on over to your terminal and run the following command: npm install netlify-cli-g, where G stands for global installation on your machine. If you're already using the Netlify CLI, make sure you update to the latest version. You can check your Netlify CLI version by running netlify --version in your terminal. Next, run the Netlify login command to authenticate with Netlify, and you're ready to roll. In this tutorial, we'll also be using the GitHub CLI to add our new project to GitHub, but you can add Git version control to your project however you like. Let's bootstrap a new Next.js app. Head on over to your terminal, run npx create-next-app and give your project a name. I'm going to name mine Next.js Netlify Middleware Demo. Next, to make the magic happen, we need the Netlify Next package. Navigate to your new project directory and run the following command in your terminal: npm install @netlify/next. Open up the project in your IDE of choice. I'm using VS Code. Let's add a new static root. Next.js offers file-based routing. Adding a JavaScript or TypeScript file into the pages directory creates a new browser root with the same name as the file. Add a new file into the pages directory named static.js. Add the following code: const page, which is a function, and let's return some basic HTML. Export default page at the bottom of the file. Start the development server using the Netlify CLI by running Netlify dev in your terminal, and a browser tab will automatically open up on localhost port 8888. Navigate to /static in your browser, and there's our new static page. We're going to pre-generate this page at build time with some base data before we transform it using middleware. By exporting a function called getStaticProps from a page, Next.js will pre-render this page at build time using the data returned by getStaticProps. At the top of static.js, export an async function getStaticProps and return one prop, message, which is a string. Pass the message prop into the page function like so, and let's print out the data. Here's the message in the browser. Now onto the middleware. Middleware in Next.js allows you to run code before an HTTP request is completed and sits in the middle of the request and response. You can create a middleware file in Next.js using JavaScript or TypeScript, and for the purposes of this tutorial, we're going to write middleware in TypeScript. At the root of your project, create a new file and name it middleware.ts. This file will run on every request when your app is running, including pages, static files, and assets. In middleware.ts, export an async function named middleware and pass in a parameter named nextRequest, which is a nextRequest object. Let's also import the type nextRequest from next/server. In this demo, we want the middleware to run on the root named static. So let's get the path name from the request and set up the function to do something when the path name starts with static. Next, it's time for the Netlify magic. Let's rewrite the HTML of the static page we created earlier. At the top of middleware.ts, Import middleware request as a named import from netlify/next. That's the package we installed earlier. And inside the middleware function, let's initialize a new Netlify middleware request, passing in the next request. Under the hood, this enhances the next request object by adding in all of the good stuff available in Netlify Edge functions. Netlify Edge functions are very much like serverless functions. You can write them using JavaScript or TypeScript, but instead of using Node.js, they are powered by Dino, an open source runtime built on web standards, and they are executed at the closest server location to a request. This enables full personalization of pages at the edge, with no need to use get server-side props in your Next.js pages. It also works with incremental static regeneration. Now the next request object is leveled up. We have the power to modify the HTTP response before it's returned, because we can actually send the request to the origin to fetch it and work with it. If the path name starts with static, let's get the next response in the HTTP chain by awaiting middlewarerequest.next. This is our static page. Now let's construct a new personalized message to replace the static page content using geolocation data that comes from the next request. Next.js Advanced Middleware from Netlify includes a replace text function and also has support for more powerful transforms using the HTML rewriter stream transformer. To get access to the message from the DOM in the middleware function, let's add an ID to the message we want to transform in the static page. And then let's run replace text on the response, passing in the DOM ID and the new message. To ensure the hydrated content on the client matches the server-side rendered HTML, and to avoid a React hydration error, we can also update page props using setPageProp to update the underlying message data on the page as well. Finally, return the response. Navigate to your static page, and the message has been transformed in the middleware file, and the HTML has been rewritten at the edge. And what's more, the page prop has also been updated. Inspect the page source, search for next underscore data in the DOM, and check out the updated page message prop, all powered by Next.js Advanced Middleware from Netlify. Let's deploy to Netlify and watch HTML rewrites happen in real time on a live URL. Next.js projects come with a Git repo already initialized. Let's stage and commit the project files. In your terminal, run git add dot to add all of your files, and then git commit dash m initial commit or whatever commit message you'd like. I'm going to add my project to GitHub, and I like to do this using the GitHub CLI. If you're using the GitHub CLI, run gh repo create in your terminal and choose push an existing local repository to GitHub. Follow the instructions in the prompts and choose to push commits from the current branch to origin. You're now all set up with version control. To initialize a new site on Netlify, run Netlify init in your terminal and choose to create and configure a new site. Choose your team and pick a site name. The CLI will ask for your build command, which has been pre-populated with next build. Press enter, and the published directory has also been pre-populated with .next. Press enter. Wait a few seconds, and your site is deployed. Here's the live site, and here's my personalized message. HTML rewrites and page prop updates in Next.js only on Netlify. If you'd like to find out more, visit Netlify's official documentation to learn about what's now possible with Next.js Advanced Middleware only on Netlify.